avant-garde, provocative, edgy, and surreal. If you haven't heard of him already, his show-stopping style has caught the attention of big Hollywood celebrities. We caught up with international and Hollywood designer Rocky Gathercole. It's a true rags-to-riches story. His challenges in life helped him define his own successes. No stranger to Hollywood, he designs for Britney Spears, Katy Perry, J.Lo, and Paris Hilton, just to name a few. We sat down with him during his welcome dinner at the Harborfront Lakeshore as he recalled and talked to us about the growing pains of childhood.
I'm really excited for this episode because today, Rocky Gathercole, renowned international designer, is with me right here at this beautiful Harborfront, diba?
Yeah.
So thanks for joining us today on the It List.
And thanks for having me.
How are you enjoying Toronto? Kasi diba first time mo dito?
I'm overwhelming.
Yeah.
It's overwhelming, actually.
What's it like for you?
I think this is the perfect place for me to stay.
Ah, ganon!
I love Canada.
Yeah. And in compared to other places, now you're based in LA, right?
Yes.
And you've been doing this for over like 25 years.
Yes.
But a lot of the feedback is that people describe your work as surreal, edgy, provocative, schizo.
Yeah,
the amount of words that describe your work. So tell us, you know, how do you get inspired with your vision?
No, I've been telling all my friends that whenever I'm happy, I'm doing the worst kind of style, like the weird, the horns, the metal.
Yeah.
That's when I'm happy.
But when
I'm sad, mm-hmm. that's the ladylike kind of dresses I'm
like
doing.
Like feminine and foamy.
Feminine, yeah.
So depending on your mood, that's what you...
At design actually depends on my mood.
Yeah. So anong mood mo? What about your Toronto collection? What is it going to be like?
It's very ladylike because here in Toronto, there's so many bawal. Like the feathers is not allowed. There's so many is not allowed here. But I come up with a very ladylike collection. Black and white.
Black and white style.
Yeah.
Yeah. And this is your first time showcasing your work, right?
Yes.
Excited.
So much. Grabe.
But it wasn't always easy for Rocky Gathercole. He came from humble beginnings in Pasay City, and for a while, he lived on the street.
At 14, I left my father and find my luck by myself. So.
Nung 14 ka lang?
14 ako nun. So I live on the street trying to make a living. It's hard because I wanted to go to school, but I have no means going to school. So after 8 years,
yeah,
I got born again Christian. I met a lot of good brethren in the church.
Yeah.
They helped me to work as a waiter in Makati. So while doing my work, may break time ako from 1:30 to 4:30. That is the time where I designed all those clothes.
So during that time that you were struggling to be, you know, an artist, doing kind of like a sketch or something like that, and that's how you came. That's how you kind of started with design.
No, when I became a waiter.
Nung kasi, waiter ka, yeah.
Kasi dun sa street, I have no dream at all to live on the street. Ang gusto mo lang makakain ka ng 3 times a day.
Mm.
And it's barely happen.
Mm.
Most of the time, once a day lang ako kumakain.
Pero nga, balik nga tayo, bakit ka umalis when you were 14? You mentioned earlier that you left your dad when you were 14.
Oh,
so.
Kasi I'm a battered child. My father is drunk every day, as in every day. So, konting mali mo lang, ginugulpi ako. I don't want to go there more.
Mm-hmm.
Maiiyak na naman ako.
Mm.
So, I love him because hindi ko kilala sarili ko pag nasa kanya ako.
Mm.
Although I really, really love him. He's the only person or human being na minahal ko ng sobra-sobra.
Mm-hmm.
Kasi nobody taught me what is love. Only tatay ko lang.
San yung mami mo?
I met my mom when I was 14.
Oh, so after nung umalis ka?
I went to her house.
Yeah.
Kaya lang di niya ako pinatuloy.
Oh, okay.
Like, she has her own family now.
Yeah.
So, I got disappointed kasi yung expectation eh, but ding ako, I'm a gay, so I'm expecting she will embrace me like her own.
Yeah.
But she never let me come in the house. Sorry, ma'am, that's the real story.
You know, that's why, I've heard a lot of success stories. And what I think, what was inspiring when I was reading a little bit about you was, kasi hindi mo ma-imagine yung obstacles na nangyari sa'yo eh. Your story is almost like rags to riches. And at that time, if you go back, that's a lot. Who knew that someone who was selling Tapsilog sa Rojas Boulevard will be designing for Katy Perry or big celebrities? You know, that's kind of out of this world, and that is a rare thing. So what does that feel like na nakikita mo yung accomplishments, yung when you look back, you see it all?
It's overwhelming.
Kasi ang laki na rin.
Ang laki, especially nung back in Manila. I'm a big fan of the Sharon Cuneta, Maricel Soriano. And nowadays, dinadamitan ko sila. Namimit ko sila ng normal right. lang. Iba talaga yung feeling.
That's really parang surreal din, no?
Oo.
CIS and Immigration has been established for more than 26 years. It is a one-stop service center for immigration service, student visa, and visitor visa.
We have been in immigration and citizen cases for more than 26 years. We have licensed consultants and lawyers to help you to fulfill your dream to come to Canada. We are here to help.
Capture every step. Capture every achievement. Capture every milestone. Capture every moment through the eyes of a cannon.
That this young kid living on the streets with one day dress up Hollywood celebrity Rocky Gathercole was born to be a designer.
Because from my understanding, wala pong formal training, but you were under somebody to be mentored.
Second year high school lang kasi ko. So, yeah. Pero magaling talaga ako mag-drawing. Tsaka mabilis ako mag-drawing. I don't do the cross things. Mm. Kasi ang practice ko comics. During my time, may comics pa every day. So, I can do a lot of expression sa drawing. I can draw, I can start from the hand, mabubuo ko yun ng tao.
Yeah.
I can start from the torso. Usually the artist or the one who went to the school, they started on the face with a cross.
Yeah.
Ako hindi.
Talagang kaya-kaya na.
Kaya ko siyang gawin and, kasi yun ang practice ko.
And speaking, since we're talking now about the technicalities, ano ba yung process? So what's the process for when you're designing? So when you're in your atelier or in your workshop, what is it like? When you go into your work mode?
Dati nagda-drawing ako eh. Nowadays, hindi na. So, pag may nakita ako, since alam ko na gusto ko, ako mismo gumagawa na sa mannequin.
So, diretso na sa mannequin?
Oo, diretso na siya sa mannequin.
Wala na yung drawing-drawing pa?
Wala na.
Oh, wow.
Not unless nag-request like Thalia.
Yeah.
I'm doing the concert of Thalia on October. Dinesign ko lahat yung ano. Paulina Rubio, I did her costume and Sia. Watch out for Sia.
Is it for a video or something?
For everything?
Oh, wow. That's amazing.
Yeah.
But, you know, it took you a while to get there, too, because you spent some time under a fashion house, right?
Yeah.
What was that like? I know, what is the fashion world like in Saudi Arabia? Take us back there. It's a different world.
In Saudi, kasi, every week may party sila.
Anong klaseng party?
Party ng mga babae. Yung babae lang, sila-sila nagpapagandahan.
Oh, ganun. So, bongga.
Bonggahan talaga.
They have lots of money.
Kaya maraming Filipino designers sa Middle East.
Oh.
Kasi yun yung nakasanayan ng mga babae doon. Party every week.
Mm.
Babae kasi more on clothes.
Right.
While the men is more on cars.
Pero ano yung, oh yes, that's sort of their luxury.
Okay, pero most of the time the guys complain dahil at least kami car once lang bibilin sila every week.
Time. But what is the fashion sense like in Saudi Arabia? Compared to say maybe here in Western. Ano ba yung gusto nila?
Very European ang mga Arabic women.
Mm-hmm.
They love European clothing. So, hindi naman nalalayo. Mas ano sila, mas feisty sila sa style.
Oh, they're a bit, they take more risks.
They love crystals.
Oh, okay.
They love artwork sa damit.
And after more than two decades of working in the United Arab Emirates under a fashion house, he decided it was time for him to go solo.
No, after Saudi for 2 years, oh. I went to Dubai.
Okay, nag-Dubai ka muna.
I stayed in Dubai for 25 years.
So what was that to experience like during those 25 years?
Okay naman, kaya lang more on routine siya. Work, sleep, work, sleep. Parang I got fed up.
So you needed a change.
Nothing is new. Wala nang bago. So, nagkataon naman, na-met ko yung business partner ko from US.
Which is your agent now.
Yeah,
right.
He's an agent now.
Yeah.
Actually, I went first to Miami Fashion Week to show my collection. Kasi
right.
Ang dream ko nun, sana kunin ako ng Victoria's Secret.
Right, kasi yun ang
kasi
parang
yun yung
style
line
na gusto ko. Yeah.
Tsaka yun yung gusto kong gawin.
Oh.
Yung mga pak-pak-pak-pak, mga kung ano-ano.
Parang lumilipad-lipad.
Kaya lang since hindi ako napansin ng Victoria's Secret, I went to New York to do another show.
Mm.
Doon nag-start, na-meet ko yung ano.
Yung agent mo.
Agent.
And then, so was there a moment when you said, okay, it's time for me to pack up and go and move
yeah,
here?
When I got fed up in Dubai,
yeah.
I called him. Sabi ko, are you serious about me like leaving Dubai for good? Oh, yeah, for sure. Iwanan mo na yan.
Pero anong time frame nun? From the time that you were there to the time that you decided, okay, I'm gonna go. Was it 2 years?
Months lang.
Months lang?
It's almost weeks nga lang eh.
What? That's amazing.
I planned it for about a month and I talked to him for 3 days or 4 days.
Yeah.
And he said, go. He gave me the go signal, so.
And then no regrets since then?
In my life, wala akong regrets. The whole 50 years, wala akong regrets. I'm just an artist in progress.
CIS and Immigration has been established for more than 26 years. It is a one-stop service center for immigration service, student visa, and visitor visa.
We have been in immigration and citizen cases for more than 26 years. We have licensed consultants and lawyers to help you to fulfill your dream to come to Canada. We are here to help.
Capture every step. Capture every achievement. Capture every milestone. Capture every moment through the eyes of a Canon.
And now in LA, you recently had, well, in North America, you recently had your fashion week in New York and Miami as well?
Yeah.
How was that for you?
It's beautiful. I love the diversity of people mm-hmm. and ideas in every places. So, well, I enjoy ko lang siya. Natutuwa ako.
Well, yeah. And I guess, you know, one of the things I was curious too is, you know, when you work with clients like the big Hollywood celebrities, ano ba yung, how does it work? Do they just like, their people call your people and then they fix it up? Or well, what is the process like? Say if Britney or Jennifer Lopez wanted something from you.
Oh, they just come to the shop, the head stylist.
Mm-hmm.
He went to the shop and choose whatever Britney might like.
Right.
Then he bring it to Britney or to J-Lo, then that's it. But most of the time they wear it.
Yeah. And have you met these celebrities too?
I met some. I talked to Britney many times.
Oh yeah? So phone?
Oh, the hill. When she wore my... I did her billboard, the red corset.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And I met a lot. Normal na nga siya, hindi ko na...
Parang ano na, parang nasanay ka na sa...
Oh, meron isang celebrity nga, like yeah. My business partner said, oh, Rocky, this celebrity is waiting for you. Okay. Are you coming? No.
Paghintayin mo na lang.
hindi kasi minsan, pag marami kang ginagawa.
Yeah.
Tapos, tsaka hindi na kasi ako na yung starstruck sa kanila. Parang, after Katy Perry,
yeah.
and that's it.
Sino yung pinakaunang starstruck mo meron ba?
Si Latoya Jackson. She went personally to our store
uh-huh.
with her limo. And I shake her hands. I love Michael Jackson.
Yeah.
Sabi ko, I love your family.
Yeah.
I love everything about your family.
The music, the style, the yeah. look, all that stuff.
So, natuwa siya. Tapos, she's almost teary-eyed. Kasi, ang dami namin napagkwentuhan kasi.
Pero antagal mo na rin sa industry. So, I mean, do you think that your style, where do you think your style is going to evolve? Or where is it heading? Even the industry itself. Because, you know, some people might say, well, not all your pieces are wearable. They're really just creative statements. Some of them are wearable. So, where do you see your collection going to evolve over time?
Last year, I had an offer from Once Upon a Time. Dito yun sinishoot eh. Yung TV show
oh,
na Once
series.
Upon a Time.
Yes, yes.
But unfortunately, it didn't work for some reason, I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
But I think I see myself doing movies and TV shows.
So ito na yung parang next step, next dream mo na.
Oo.
Yeah. Like designing, a costume design is what it
yeah.
is? Yes, for movies? Yay!
That's what
you.
I like.
Many are inspired. Not just by his vision and creativity, but his story of overcoming what seemed near impossible.
It's truly an honor because the amount of people I see when they hear about how crazy Rocky Gathercole's collection is,
mm-hmm.
and for someone they know to be wearing that, it's truly a memorable experience. And for me to be wearing something, it's going to be very incredible.
How did you first hear about his work and his collection in Rocky?
Through a friend.
Mm-hmm.
And when I started doing my research, I was very amazed just to see the kind of history Rocky's gone through
mm-hmm.
and to where he is now. It
right.
truly makes me believe dreams do come true.
CIS and Immigration has been established for more than 26 years. It is a one-stop service center for immigration service, student visa, and visitor visa.
We have been in immigration and citizen cases for more than 26 years. We have licensed consultants and lawyers to help you to fulfill your dream to come to Canada. We are here to help.
Capture every step. Capture every achievement. Capture every milestone. Capture every moment through the eyes of a cannon.
Arts presented Rocky's collection hitting the runway for the first time in Canada, and his theme was called Redemption. His designs transitioned from black to white and finished with gold colors. That edgy, futuristic, out-of-this-world look that came to life from his creative mind. It was a showstopper. And the audience loved him back, as he looked to them with humility and grace.
Sobrang saya ko dahil sobrang saya nyo. Yun yung mas ano, mas it's so gratifying.
Yeah.
Yung feeling, grabe. Basta hindi ko to ina-expect somehow, pero ibang klase sa Canada. I really love it here. Ibang klase ang audience.
Yeah. How is it different from your shows from Miami that you've done? Iba yung audience ba?
Iba eh, tsaka dito masyadong personal.
Mm.
They hug me, everybody wants to have photo with me. May mga nagpa-autograph pa.
Parang hindi ka naman sanay.
Hindi pa.
Hindi pa? Why Redemption? What does it mean
Kasi
for you?
Few months ago, marami kami pinagdaanan nitong agent ko, na best friend ko. So sabi ko, by putting Redemption as a title, I have the full collection. Mm-hmm. Para pakita sa tao na, this is what I can do. Simple lang talaga ako. It's just yung iba lang talaga idea ko sa mga damit.
Ibang iba because a lot of your work is, you know, described as avant-garde or surreal, very futuristic. And that's what sets you apart from other designers, right? So where do you get that creative vision? But particularly for your show today, how do you even come up with that design?
Hollywood based na kasi ko eh. So yung mga damit talaga, I'll make sure na pang Hollywood siya. That the glitter and glamour of Hollywood is there. And at the same time, I love what I'm doing. Yung kumbaga, pag gusto nyo kasi, mas gusto ko eh. Pag mahal nyo, mas mahal ko. Parang ganun. So, ganun lang kasimple.
And you've been, you know, you've designed for, like you said, Hollywood celebrities. but you didn't actually, it didn't come very easy for you. We've heard your story. So what does it feel like na, wow, you know, you've come so far and, you know, this is what you're doing now. It's almost like a, it's a, like a miracle. So what does that feel like?
Actually, sobrang na-enjoy ko na lang ang buhay ko ngayon. And, basta overwhelming. At my age now, hindi ko na-expect na darating sa akin tong ganito na people will appreciate what I'm doing. Tapos, everyone or halos lahat ng ano, part of the world, ini-invite ako mag-show. Mm-hmm. Like, meron ako sa Colombia soon and Australia. Hindi ko na alam may isang gagawin ko.
So, like, you know, you're being booked up kasi you're so talented. And, like, your creation right here with Calvin. Do you want to talk about that? Yung futuristic niya?
Oo. Ito yung, ano, more on parang gladiator, futuristic kind of style. Look at the hand. Talagang, ako ang nag-design yan.
Wow. Kumbaga,
details talaga. I'll make sure na makakagalaw yung mga fingers niya.
Yeah, what type of material is that?
It's a silver sheets.
Oh, wow.
In order pa siya.
And what's next for you? You know, you're gonna evolve your style, but are you looking for other projects?
There's a lot of projects coming with this beautiful woman beside me. We better ask her about it.
Tell us.
When is the next project?
Yeah.
Well, for Canada, so there's one coming on September, so it's going to be because Rocky Gathercole, you can actually book him every month, and the collection is totally different from the other. Like, months ago, that was really gold collection, shimmery gold in New York. Now look at the black and white now. Mm-hmm. So September, it's going to be?
Embrace color.
So September, he's going to be back. So just watch out on some posters and print ads for his coming back.
So how does it feel for you to represent him in his work here in Canada?
It's very humbling.
Yeah.
Like for someone like, you know, as I always say, like I'm a fan of his artistry first. Mm-hmm. But what really like drawn me to Rocky is his being down to earth. Talagang, I brought him to Ryerson University because I said, like, would you like to inspire some fashion design students? And I told them, like, the person that you're looking at now, it's totally the opposite of what he creates. Mm-hmm. So we walk around, he would request for top silog. You would never know that this is the guy that, you know, Britney Spears or Katy Perry is looking for his creation. I am so blessed. I mean, like, pag sundo ko nga siya sa airport, pumorma pa ako eh. Kasi di ba nag-effort ako.
Nag-effort?
Ano nakita ko naman siya, parang hindi naman pala siya ganun. All the volunteers, especially my partner, JC, Jatender Johal, for like working hard with me for months just to bring Rocky here in Canada. So it's crazy because on the months that we're working together, we're always together. For the last 5 days before the show, we didn't see each other. She has to work on the other part of the production, and I have to work on the other part of the production. So for all my friends, for all my volunteers, especially my partner Jatinder Johal, thank you so much for making it possible to bring an artist like Rocky Gathercole.
Thank you very much for watching The Eat List.
Despite his successes and, you know, Rocky overcoming personal struggles, he says at the age of 50, he has no regrets. Up next, he actually wants to design costumes for Hollywood films. And soon in September, as you've heard, he's going to have another show here in Toronto. So stay tuned. You're watching The A-List. Until next week.
Coming up next week, nationalism and street style meets with a Filipinas clothing company, plus Dre Peo serenades us with a Spanish song called Duele el Corazon, only on The 8 List. Si me das, yo te mente, doy mi amor, bailamos hasta la 10.